Alright, what is going on, guys? It's Sparks here. Today I'm doing an updated NAT video. I'm going to show you guys how to get rid of that strict NAT on your Xbox One. Today, though, we're doing something a bit differently, and I'm going to focus on a very specific piece of hardware, and that is an all-in-one modem router by Rogers, which is a Canadian carrier, called the CGN3ROG. It's a Hitron router modem. You might have one from your ISP. These things seem to be super common. And so the first steps are going to be on the console. So what we're going to do is we're going to press the middle button. We're going to scroll all the way to the right side. We're going to go to settings. In settings, we're going to go to network and then network settings. And then in here, we're going to go to advanced settings. Within this pane, I'll explain a bit. You'll see a couple of options on the left side, and mostly a very advanced layout of your console on your network. So things from what type of IP address it has, DNS, wired MAC address, wireless MAC address, and your port. And the port actually is the thing we're here for. You'll see an option on the left-hand side saying alternate port selection. We want to select that. And then we want to go to manual, and you're going to select a port from this list. You're just going to want to write it down, take a picture, remember whatever port you set for this, because this port is going to replace a default port that the Xbox generally uses, and I'll mention more about that later. So once that's done, you should probably come back to the advanced settings screen, take down all the information, most notably the IP address of your console. Is because we're gonna need it. So we're gonna switch over to the PC now, and here we have the login for the Hitron CGN3. You can see the IP address that these devices generally have is 192.168.0.1. That's how you access this page. Just open a browser, type that in, and it should bring you to this page. Now, the unfortunate thing is that they don't really secure these things all that well. So the username is cusadmin, so C-U-S-A-D-M-I-N, and the general password that you get with it is just password. I would recommend you go in and change it. I'm gonna log in. Mine's not password anymore. I've since changed mine, but you'll see this screen once you log in. This is your status page. We're not going to do anything here. We're actually going to be doing a lot in the LAN setup, gateway function, and port forwarding. So for the basics, first off, we're going to go into gateway function and disable UPnP. And then save your changes. And the reason I say this is because the way this modem functions is it does port listening. It listens for ports and then writes specific rules in your port forwarding for those ports. The problem is if you set ports in the port forwarding and it thinks it should overwrite them, it overwrites them. Not a good thing if you want to keep an open NAT. So next steps is we're going to reserve your IP for your Xbox. And you can do that by going to LAN setup and then going to DHCP reservation. And you'll see a whole list of different items here. Find your Xbox in the client name. If you can't find your Xbox in the client name or you've renamed your Xbox and forgot it, just use the IP address you took down earlier in that advanced settings panel. And then click add. Once you click add, it will show up down here in the clients already reserved, and you can save your changes. Once you save your changes, I would suggest turning your console off and turning your console on just to make sure that the IP address has stayed the same. It's not necessary, but because you're gonna do it at the end of this process anyway, but it's something to keep in mind. And then the next step is to go into port forwarding. And we're going to start adding ports. And so adding ports is simple. You can see all the ports I have here labeled Xbox Live 1 are Xbox ports, except for this one. This is also an Xbox port. This is the port that you set earlier on the Xbox. So remember what that port is or what you set it to. And so I'm just going to give you a little tutorial. you know, actually I'll go into managing one of these ports so you can get an overview of how it looks. So in the application name, you're going to add whatever you like, whatever you want to name it. I usually call them Xbox Live and then a number because there are more than one port. The protocol is very specific for each port, and I'm going to go back to the screen that's just visible behind there, and you'll be able to pause the video and check what protocol is used. So in this case, it's UDP, but usually the protocols that will be used are either UDP, TCP, or TCP/UDP, which means both. So in your public and private range ports, you're going to always have the same number or whatever range it's requesting. Most of them, it's just a number. And then in your local IP, you're going to have the IP address of the console itself. Once that's done, you don't have to worry about either of these two, and you're just going to click apply. In my case, I'm not going to because I already have them set up. But here, I'm going to mark on screen right now all the ports that you need to add to your port forwarding list for your console. Actually, I'll give you a second to pause and do your thing. Okay, now that you've done that, be sure to save. And there's two more steps, and they're fairly simple. You're just going to go into the admin panel. You're going to go to device reset, and you're going to reboot your device. This is going to do a reboot without you actually going physically to the modem and rebooting it. And the other thing you're going to do is you're going to hard reset your Xbox. And the way to do that is you press down on the on button and hold it until it turns off. And from there, you should be good to go. So hopefully you guys got a lot out of this video. If you have a Hitron from Rogers or any other company, you can use this tutorial. The interface is generally the same all the time, so you shouldn't worry. Whether you have the black model like in the thumbnail or the white model that they're giving out now, all of them should work. So thanks again for watching. Hopefully this tutorial is great. If you liked it, smash that like button, and I will see you guys later. Peace out.